Hey everybody, and welcome to a tutorial video on how to launch the second generation IS250 and IS350 as well. Mine is the IS250, and I'm gonna be going step by step what to do in order to get the perfect launch. Overall, it's fairly easy, so without further ado, let's get to it. Now, before the first step, you need to make sure your car is properly warmed up. Of course, your aircon must be off for better acceleration. And as you can see, this needle needs to be in the middle to be on the optimal engine temperature. Also, a small tip, make sure your fuel tank is, well, not really empty, but to be like mine, not too empty, but not full, because if you have a full tank, this Lexus can hold 65 or 70 liters. So you are putting additional weight of 65 to 70 kilos. So yeah, just some small tips. But the first step is to turn off the traction control. How to do that is, some Lexuses, while you are in park, you have to hold the traction control button for like 3 seconds. And as you can see, there's the icon here telling me that it's completely off. Now, for Lexuses, before the refresh, you have to do the, as people call it, pedal dance. I will show you a diagram of what you have to do. On to the step two, put your car in sport mode. And there's a button here that says like power. Just press that and the car will have a much more sensitive gas pedal. And the overall programming of the transmission is gonna behave a bit more sportier. So that's a must, you have to do that. Otherwise, your car will feel a bit sluggish off the line. And you will be indicated that you are in sport mode by this green icon, ECT power. Step three will be to put the transmission into sport mode, which is this position. And there's, you can see here, it's number four. So what that means is the transmission will shift by itself until you get to fourth gear. But for 0 to 100 or 0 to 60 miles per hour, you only need two or three gears. Car will automatically change the gear in the best way possible, because if you try to shift by yourself, this transmission is not perfect. It has a bit of a delay when you upshift. So to be on a safe side, just put it in fourth and the transmission is gonna do its thing. You just have to keep pressing the gas. But if you want to have some fun, you can switch to first gear and shift into second. Just don't react too late on changing gears. And now you're basically ready to launch. This is how the gauge cluster looks like. There's a blinking seatbelt light. You have to put the seatbelt before you do any kind of testing. The engine is at the optimal temperature, so you're ready to go. Now, since my Lexus is automatic, not a manual, you don't have a clutch to set the higher RPM and just dump the clutch. With the automatic, there's a way to still launch it properly without needing a clutch. So what you have to do is press really hard on the brake. And when you press it, you can, don't be scared, you can press the gas a little bit to get to your desired RPM. I don't recommend going over 3000 RPMs, but the sweet spot for this Lexus is, I think, around 1500 RPM, depending on how good your tires are and the dimensions. If it's wider, then you can go for a bit higher RPM. I put it in drive, I'm pressing the brake hard, and the car is not going anywhere because I'm pressing the brake. But don't hold on to the high RPMs so long. Quickly press the throttle to get to the desired RPM that you want, and then release the brake. Don't hold to the higher RPMs for so long, because it's not doing good to the transmission. So just do this and then let go of the brake. I will show you how I did the launch very well. Of course, do this at your own risk and do it somewhere where there's no traffic or at the track. Don't launch it repeatedly. Take a bit of breaks between launches if you're gonna do multiple launches. Lastly, make sure to check and set the proper tire pressure for your car. I suggest you to just follow the what Lexus recommends for each tire, and this is the location where you can read for many types of tire dimensions. And lastly, if you have some heavy stuffs in your trunk, make sure to remove them, because that's also gonna help the acceleration. So that's about it. And good luck. I hope this video was helpful to you. Thank you for watching, and make sure to subscribe for more Lexus videos. Bye.